everyone, welcome to Studio Classroom on the Air. This is the place to come when you want to have some fun. My name is Rebecca. Can you think of any activity that's better than reading a good book? Just imagine being snuggled up on your bed on a rainy afternoon with a delicious cup of hot chocolate. Maybe this is your idea of a Saturday afternoon, and you are wondering just where you can get started reading a new book. Well, there are so many wonderful options to check out. Today, our lesson is called The World's Coolest Bookstores. That's right, we're talking about bookstores around the world. And here are a few fun phrases that you are going to learn today. First, chances are, and plenty more. Well, friends, open up your magazines, and it's time for us to go find a good book. Well, at least learn about some good bookstores. So come with me.
The World's Coolest Bookstores. A trip to the bookstore is no longer just for buying books. Where did you buy your last book? Chances are you bought it on the internet. But if you did, you missed the remarkable experience of browsing in a real bookstore. These days, bookstores offer lots of great books and plenty more.
Taipei's Esleet Dunan Store.
Time magazine once named Esleet's Dunan Store in Taipei Asia's best bookstore. One visit to the store tells you why.
Well, let's get right into our lesson as we talk about some of the world's coolest bookstores. Now, Gabe, typically when you go to a bookstore, what is the purpose for going to a bookstore?
To browse, for me anyway. I'm not necessarily going to buy a book. I just like looking through bookstores. There are shelves and shelves of books. And I used to go to look at perhaps the theater section or like the arts section, which might have books on theater. But yeah, actually some bookstores sell games too. I like to buy games and play games. They sell little things like bookmarks and mugs as well. So it's kind of fun to just look through. And what's great about bookstores is that they're quiet and peaceful.
That's right. They're quiet and peaceful. And perhaps it's a great place to spend some time reading. Well, our lesson says a trip to the bookstore is no longer just for buying books. So perhaps at one time, if you went to a bookstore, you were probably on a mission to buy a book.
So we have a question here. Where did you buy your last book? That's a good question for you to think about. The last book that you bought somewhere, where did you buy that book?
Well, I've got an answer.
Yes?
On the internet.
Oh, is that right?
That's right. And actually, that's what our lesson says. Chances are you bought it on the internet. How did our lesson know? That's where I bought my last book.
I think I bought my last book at my college university campus. I visited recently and I bought some books there. But anyway, we do see a phrase here in this sentence, chances are something. Rebecca, can you tell us about that phrase?
Well, this just means that it is very likely that something happened.
Now, I don't know about you, Rebecca, but whenever I use this phrase, I always emphasize the word are.
Oh, right.
It sounds like you could read, chances are you bought it on the internet. But I always like to pronounce it, chances are you bought it on the internet. Do you do that?
I do that too. I usually emphasize the R. I don't usually say chances are. It's usually chances are.
Yeah.
Yeah. You really emphasize that A-R-E.
When I was visiting my parents recently, they live in Jiayi. And so if I come back to Taipei on Sunday afternoon, if I try to go right in the middle of the afternoon, chances are we hit traffic. It happens almost every time. If I leave at midnight, chances are the traffic will be less.
And of course, when we're talking about books and where you bought your last book, our lesson says chances are you bought it on the internet. But if you did, you missed the remarkable experience of browsing in a real bookstore. These days, bookstores offer lots of great books and plenty more. Let's take a look at this phrase, plenty more. This just means that there is a lot more in addition to what was already mentioned.
Right. Okay. So you could also use this phrase to talk about there is more of what you already have. So for example, if you need something else to drink at this party, there is plenty more on the table. All right. You have a drink in your hand of apple juice or something. There's plenty more over there. You can just go and get some more. But yeah, like Rebecca said, often we use this phrase to talk about something that's not referred to yet. So not only books at a bookstore. Like before I mentioned, you could buy bookmarks and mugs and coasters and perhaps even t-shirts, depending on the bookstore.
That's right. Okay, so now it's time for us to get into some of these bookstores. Some of the coolest bookstores around the world. The first bookstore is actually found in Taipei, and it's Taipei's Eslit Duanam store. Is that how you say that word?
Yeah, Duanan.
Duanan. Mm-hmm. I've never been there, but I've seen pictures, and it looks beautiful.
Well, right. Actually, Eslit is a very famous bookstore all over the island, right? And you could find it in different places and different cities. I like visiting the Eslit bookstores. And we read here, Time magazine once named Eslit's Dunan bookstore, or Dunan store in Taipei, Asia's best bookstore. One visit to the store tells you why, and we'll find out more later.
That's right. It just kind of ends like that. Now, you know something, Gabe? I really like buildings that are made from brick. I think that brick is so beautiful on the outside and mortar stone.
Rebecca, I think you're talking about real stores that you can actually walk into and buy something. We call that a brick and mortar store as opposed to buying something on the internet. Let's take a look at what brick and mortar stores are in the
InfoCloud.
Hello, friends. Welcome to InfoCloud. Nowadays, you can buy just about anything online and have it delivered straight to your doorstep.
It's true, but I still love going to a brick and mortar store. I prefer that to just shopping online.
Oh, great phrase, Rex. Today, let's talk about what we mean when we say brick and mortar store.
This term refers to a store that has a physical, real location as opposed to one that is only online.
Brick and mortar refer to the materials used to make the walls of a building. Mortar is the substance that allows the bricks to stay together.
Although we often use this term in opposition to online stores, it's a term that has actually been around for quite a while.
But once companies like Amazon and Netflix began shaking up their respective markets, brick and mortar stores entered our everyday language.
That's likely because people were talking about how brick and mortar bookstores and movie rental shops were disappearing.
Here's the strange thing. After online shopping took over the market, you now have Amazon looking into operating brick and mortar stores. Strange, right?
Hey everyone, welcome back to Studio Classroom. Do you enjoy books? Do you enjoy going to bookstores? Well then, you're probably going to want to check out some of these cool bookstores around the world that we are talking about in today's lesson. Now, we've already started talking about Taipei's Eslit bookstore, and we have more to learn about this really cool bookstore, so let's do that now.
The world's coolest bookstores. The store, spread across 5 floors, offers a combination of restaurants, music, and over 200,000 books. With its cozy reading spots, visitors sometimes say it's like a library. Others have called it the 7-Eleven of bookstores because it's open 24 hours a day. Sariva Bookstore. Rio de Janeiro's Saraiva Bookstore might be the world's most colorful bookstore. The visible upper level is lined with books arranged by their colors. This rainbow effect provides a colorful greeting for shoppers as they arrive. A rainbow path also leads young readers into the children's section.
Well, of course, we're talking about Esleet bookstores, and there are actually many different branches around Taipei, a lot of different locations, and some of the bookstores are quite beautiful.
Yeah, you know, in the previous section, we looked at a picture of the one at the Songshan Cultural and Creative Park, and I really like that one. But of course, there are different branches in different parts of Taipei, and the one we're learning about in our lesson is very big. It has a lot of restaurants, over 200,000 books. There's a lot of things that make it special.
And we continue learning about this Esleet bookstore with its cozy reading spots. Visitors sometimes say it's like a library. And the reason why it's like a library is because you can go find a cozy spot and do some reading.
Right. What's a library without places to just kind of sit and read comfortably, right? We read here, others have called it the 7-Eleven of bookstores because it's open 24 hours a day.
And there's a phrase in here that we would like to talk about, and that is the something of something. Now, of course, we see the word the 7-Eleven of bookstores. This is kind of like a metaphor where something more familiar is used to kind of give you a reference point for something that is less known.
That's right. Everybody knows about 7-Eleven. It's a convenience store, and it's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, right? So now they're helping you to understand what this bookstore is like by comparing it to 7-Eleven. It's the 7-Eleven of bookstores. If you want to describe something to somebody who's not familiar with your town, you could use something famous that they know. So for example, say someone doesn't know about Coco, the tea shop. Mm. You could say, well, actually, it's kind of like the Starbucks of tea shops here in Taipei.
Ah, that's an excellent example, because most people know about Starbucks, right? Mm-hmm. And so now all of a sudden, they have an idea of what Coco's might be like. Mm-hmm. Well, okay, we've learned a little bit about the first bookstore. Now it's time to move to the second bookstore, world famous bookstore. This is Saraiva Bookstore, or Saraiva Bookstore, more like it. We read, Rio de Janeiro, Saraiva Bookstore might be the world's most colorful bookstore.
The visible upper level is lined with books arranged by their colors. And before we continue, let's take a look at that word or that phrase, to be lined with something.
Ooh, it's a great phrase to know, or a great word to know, more like it. This just means that you use something and you create a line with that something. So basically, it's arranged with an item of some sort.
Okay, so for another way to use this, basically anything that you see, maybe different things put together and they create what looks like a line, you can say that is lined with something. You look out the window and you see a lot of cars parked along the side of the street. There's a line of cars, or the street is lined with cars. All the people got out of their cars to go and get some nice fried chicken before getting back on the road. But now the street is lined with cars.
And of course, in our lesson, we're talking about a bookstore, a colorful bookstore, and how the visible upper level is lined with books arranged by their colors. That's actually rather special, I guess. They keep all the blues together, the reds together, the purples together. Rather beautiful.
So it creates a rainbow effect, right? This rainbow effect provides a colorful greeting for shoppers as they arrive. Rebecca, maybe you should rearrange things in your house so that it looks like a rainbow when people come in.
You know, that's a great idea. I did consider that after I read through this lesson, but then I thought, I just don't have the time to arrange everything by color at this time. But maybe in the future.
Maybe in the future. Well, we read on here, a rainbow path also leads young readers into the children's section. So it sounds like there is something for everybody. Okay, well, a couple times a month, we do like to visit different places and get a picture of what those places are like. I think right now it's time for us to join Dave as he tells us something about Rio de Janeiro.
Good afternoon, friends. Dave here, and I am thrilled to share with you some of the greatest sights and tastes of Rio de Janeiro. When you think of Rio, you may think of the clear waters and blue skies, but there is so much more. If you're a sports enthusiast, take a seat at the Maracanã Stadium, one of the largest football, that's soccer, stadiums in the world. While you're there, wave the flag of your favorite team. And if you prefer nature, the Jardim Botânico is a great option. It has over 8,000 species of plants, including 600 types of orchids. And Sugarloaf Mountain and the glass-walled cable car ride is a fantastic way to get a beautiful 360-degree view of Rio. It only takes 6 minutes. And for those who love an adrenaline rush, climbing Corcovado may just be for you. It's a 710-meter climb. When you reach the peak, the top, you sit back, relax, and enjoy the view of the city. And if you want something different but equally exciting, paragliding in Pedra Bonita could be for you. It's a windy ride, but it's worth it. Paragliders take off from a mountain, hill, or sometimes even the ground. The ride takes about 15 to 20 minutes. Well, if you're into history, you won't want to miss one of the most famous sites of the whole world, the Christ the Redeemer statue, located in the heart of Rio. It's another one of the new seven wonders of the world. And finally, before you leave Brazil, visiting the Churrascaria restaurant is a must. With the numerous sides, salads, and endless charred meat, you won't be just eating anywhere. You'll be drooling and thinking about it for days. It was so great hanging out with you today, but it's time for us to say goodbye. So, catch you next time on SC Travel.
Hey everyone, it's been so much fun learning about different bookstores because I love bookstores. I love big bookstores and small bookstores, cute bookstores, and floating bookstores. Okay friends, it's been fun learning about two different types of bookstores today. We have more for you next time, so come back right here on Studio Classroom.